तो क्या हो रहा है यहाँ पे, जो कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन आप स्टोर कर रहे हो कंप्यूटर में वो सीधा कहाँ जाता है, इट इज़ गोइंग इनसाइड योर रैम वेयर इट स्टेज वाइल द कंप्यूटर इज ऑन। ठीक है, ये समझो ये पॉइंट को। एनी इंफॉर्मेशन फेड इन टू द कंप्यूटर इज स्टोर्ड इन द रैम वेयर इट स्टेज वाइल द कंप्यूटर इज ऑन। RAM is a temporary storage unit and once if the computer is switched off, the data gets completely erased. आप कोई भी काम कर रहे हो कंप्यूटर में, डेटा और इंफॉर्मेशन स्टोर कर रहे हो, वो डायरेक्टली जाके RAM में स्टोर हो जाएगा जाएगा। बट वंस जैसे ही एंटर करते हुए, जैसे ही पावर स्विच ऑफ हो गया, so whatever you have stored in your RAM will completely gets erased. There are two types of RAM, that is your static and dynamic. Static and dynamic. Okay. So what is what do you mean by random access memory? That is RAM. What happens over here is whichever information that you are storing into your RAM, it will directly go and sit in your RAM only when your computer is on. But once the computer is switched off or power goes off, the data whatever is been stored in your RAM gets completely erased. Hence RAM is called as a temporary storage unit. It is called as a temporary storage unit. There are two types of RAM, that is static and dynamic RAM. Okay, I'll just show you the picture of a RAM. I expect that everyone knows what is a RAM, but still I will just show you a RAM picture. So this is a RAM picture. Okay, which is in your CPU fixed to your motherboard. I've told each and every components of a computer working is been fixed in your motherboard. Okay, and your motherboard in turn has been attached to your CPU. Fine, this is your RAM. Okay, then another one memory is there, that is called as the read-only memory. It is a non-volatile memory. It is called as a non-volatile memory, whereas random access memory is called as a temporary storage unit. Okay. Now, what is this non-volatile memory? This means that the information feds gets permanently stored and is saved even when the power computer is switched off. Okay, hence it is called as a non-volatile memory. Once again, I'll repeat, what happens in RAM is you store your data and information into your RAM only when your computer is on. Once your computer is switched off, whatever data you have stored will get erased in your RAM. Whereas in your ROM, what happens is the information that you have fed is permanently stored in your ROM, even though if your computer gets switched off in between. Matlab, jaise hi power supply gaya aur aapne data aur information isme store kiya, fir bhi rahega aapke ROM mein. RAM mein waisa nahi rahega. Jaise hi power supply gaya to aapka information kya ho raha hai wahan pe, erase ho raha hai. Clear? Okay, one disadvantage in your ROM is that data stored in your ROM cannot be modified or erased. आपको changes नहीं कर सकते आप data जो ROM में store किया है. Modify means क्या? Modified means what? Changes cannot be done, nor you can erase it off. Okay, now there are three types of ROM. This you will be learning later on in your higher classes. दैट इज PROM, दैट इज PROM, प्रोग्रामेबल ROM, प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी, EPROM, इरेजेबल प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी, EPROM, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिकली इरेजेबल प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी. ओके, यू जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द फुल फॉर्म्स. यू आर सपोज टू स्टडी द फुल फॉर्म्स फॉर दिस. दैट इज प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी, इरेजेबल प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी, इलेक्ट्रिकली इरेजेबल प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी. क्लियर? I'll just show you the picture of a ROM right now. Just look into it. See, yeah, this is the picture of a ROM. This is the picture of a RAM. In RAM, what happens? This is a temporary memory. Wherein which what happens over here is whatever data and information that you have stored is erased if your computer is switched off. Whereas in your ROM, read only memory, this is called as a non-volatile memory, because the data and information whatever you are storing in your ROM, what happens, it will not get erased even though your computer is switched off. But one disadvantage is that is what, that the data which you have stored in ROM cannot get modified and erased. Okay, all understood the difference between RAM and ROM? Fine. The next one is the disk drive. The disk drive, it makes the user to read, write, delete and modify any data on the storage disk. Now, I expect that disk drive is again fixed into your CPU. It is inside your CPU. Okay. Kyun rehta hai disk drive? Aapko yes, CD, DVD sab insert karne ke liye. Aur wo CD aur DVD ke andar kya dalte ho aap? Aapke information ko store karte ho. Makes the user to read. Aap read bhi kar sakte ho. It makes the user to write or delete or modify any data on the storage disk. There are several types of disk drives, that is a hard disk drive, a DVD drive, a CD drive, but the most common one that we are using is a hard disk drive. Okay, I'll just show you the picture of a hard disk drive. This is the picture of a hard disk drive, okay, which is fixed inside your CPU. Can you see a CD in that? Can you see a CD which has been fixed in your hard disk drive? Okay. The next one is the switch mode power supply. That is the SMPS. Switch mode power supply, SMPS. It is essential for the safe running of the power consuming electrical and electronic appliance. What does it do? It transfers the electric power from the source of alternating current, that is AC, to the low voltage direct current, that is DC. Okay, it is essential for the safe running of the power consuming the electrical and electronic appliance. It transfers the electric power from the source of alternating current AC to the low voltage direct current. Okay, I'll just show you the picture of SMPS. So yeah, this is a SMPS. This is the SMPS. Okay, it is somewhat like a fan type which is fixed in your CPU. Okay. So what does this do? It transfers the electrical power from the AC to the low voltage direct current DC. Fine. So these are the various components that has been fixed into your CPU and in turn it has been fixed to your motherboard also. I'll just have a glance or a repetition. Okay, repetition of what and all I have told you about the internal hardware components till now. Okay, I'll repeat once again saying that internal hardware components means the hardware components which are inside the CPU of a computer system. Whichever is there inside the CPU of a computer system, within the internal hardwares, the internal peripherals, the things which are inside the CPU that you are learning. The first thing is that is the motherboard that you learned. So each and every peripheral is in turn connected to your motherboard. Okay, this is the main board of the main part of a computer. If you don't have a motherboard, that means you cannot work at all with that of your computer. Okay, a motherboard consists of a base. The base of a motherboard has a firm plastic sheet. The motherboard gets its name from the fact that the board